Okay, today we are going to start our revision for the assessment, second assessment exam for biology, which will include chapter 7, all of chapter 7, section 1, 2, 3, 4, and two lessons from chapter 8, lesson 1, section 1, and section 2. Today we are trying to cover all the material included in chapter 7. Let's start first with the first section in chapter 7, which is talking about chromosomes and phenotype. The concept of our lesson was that chromosomes in which genes are located can affect the expression of a trait. Okay, so we learned before, and then we have a chromosome, and each chromosome is made of genes, and the genes are located on each gene located on this chromosome can affect the expression of the trait. Okay, many human genetic disorders caused by autosomally. Now, most of your traits and disorders are caused by the autosomal genes. Who can tell me what are the two types of genes that we have on the chromosomes? Yes, Jane.
We have. Oh, can you repeat the question, please?
What are the two types of genes that are located on the chromosomes?
We have autosome and sex chromosome.
And sex what?
Chromosomes.
Ada, if I ask you about the chromosome type, but if I ask you about the gene type, yes, Abdullah.
Teacher, I was just going to answer.
The same answer?
Autosomes and sex chromosomes, yes.
Adola, the types of chromosomes. Types of chromosomes are autosomes and sex chromosomes. I'm asking about the genes. The genes that located on the autosomes, what we call them. And the two types of genes. What are they? في عندي genes على الأوتوزومز وفي عندي genes على السكس كروموسومز. صح؟ هدول هم التو تايبس. The genes that located on the autosomes نسميهم autosomal genes. And what we call the autosomes, the genes that located on the sex chromosomes. Who remember? Yes, Jane?
Six-linked gene.
أيوه. So you have to be more specific and take care for the question. When I ask you the types of the chromosomes, you tell me we have autosomes. Chromosome 1 to 22, هدول autosomes. Chromosome 23, six chromosomes. These are six chromosomes. كل chromosome عليه genes. The genes that located on the autosomes, هم من 1 to 22, نسميهم autosomal genes. And the genes that located on the 60 chromosomes, نسميهم six linked genes. Okay? عشان أنا في عندي some trait, okay, caused by autosomal genes. في عندي disorder, most of your traits, يعني أغلب الترايت اللي عندنا إحنا كلها من وين أخذناها؟ من الأوتوزومال genes, اللي هم genes that located on the autosomes. And there are some disorders are caused by six linked genes, اللي هم على X chromosome. You remember now? Okay. طيب هلا إذا many genetic disorders أو most of the genetic disorders أو traits that you have caused by autosomal genes, not sex-linked genes. But on the other hand, there are some disorders that are affected by sex-linked genes. هلا the chance of having disorder can be predicted. You use the same principle as Mendel. How we can predict the disorders by using the principle of Mendel, اللي هم dominant or recessive, heterozygous, or homozygous. What we call the person of heterozygous, if the person is heterozygous for a disease or for a disorder, what we call this person? Yes, Jane.
Carrier.
ايش يعني اعطيني example of heterozygous genotype يا Jane.
T capital and T small.
Bravo. إذا كان عندي two alleles different, one dominant, one recessive, معناته هذا heterozygous. صح؟ إذا كانوا two recessive تنتين T small T small هدول هوموزايغوس. تنتين dominant T capital T capital هدول هوموزايغوس. Dominant هذولك هوموزايغوس recessive. When you have one dominant one recessive, that means the person is heterozygous, which means it is a carrier. And does the carrier show the symptoms of the disease, Ya Abdullah? Does the carrier show the symptoms of the disease, Ya Abdullah?
Oh, yeah, sorry, teacher. I thought I was on.
Does yes, the teacher. Carrier, the carrier show the symptoms of the disease in the autosomal right.
Disease? Yes.
Yes? The carrier, I told you.
The carrier?
Time. Yes.
Oh, okay, no, they don't.
Carrier, they have the allele. They have the allele because it's heterozygous, but it dominant will cover the recessive, so it doesn't show the disease. It has the allele, but it doesn't show the disease. صح؟ تمام. هلا هون في عندي أنا disorders caused by هلا نحكي عن الأوتوزومال جين أو the disorders that caused on the autosomal gene أو affected by the autosomal gene اللي هم عندي two disorders. أخذنا example of طبعا most of your traits are affected or located على the genes on the autosome. يعني the hair color والeye color هدول كلهم they are affected أو the genes هدول located وين على the autosome من 1 ل 22. And at the same time, there are some disorders caused also on the genes على الأوتوزومز هم من 1 to 22. في عندي disorders أمراض caused by dominant allele. يعني one dominant allele will show the disease or disorder. And there are disorders caused by recessive allele. هلا the disorders that caused by dominant alleles هم less common. They don't يعني you don't find a lot of cases from these disorders. They are less common than recessive disorders. They mean the Huntington's disease. And we said that this is a disease that damages nervous system and usually appears during adulthood. It doesn't show the symptoms before adulthood. It shows the symptoms during adulthood, okay? And 75% chance if both parents heterozygous. The kind of two parents heterozygous, يعني عندهم one of them, both of them have a dominant allele, 75% chance for the offspring to have a disease. Now, since the disease strikes later in life, person can have children before disease appears. Yani if this person get married and he didn't, the disease doesn't strike and doesn't show the symptoms, maybe he will get married and have children before he appears, the disease appears, and this allele will pass on even though disease is fatal. It will pass. He don't know before marriage. Maybe he don't know that he have a disease. After marriage, this allele was transmitted to the offspring, his children, and because he didn't see the disease didn't appear. هاي مشكلته in Huntington's disease. It doesn't show symptoms before adulthood, during adulthood or after حتى. Okay? إذن هذا one disorder that caused على autosomal genes. Disorder caused by recessive allele اللي هو caused by recessive alleles on the autosome and must have two copies of recessive allele to have a disorder. لما يقول لك recessive allele معناته لازم two of the alleles should be recessive. وهدول لما يكون عندي انا البيرنتس ار هيتروزايغوس يعني انا عندي one parent carrier سي كابيتال سي سمول زي cystic fibrosis وال other parent is also heterozygous سي كابيتال سي سمول most of the time ال offspring disorders often appear in offspring of parents who are heterozygous and when cross happen between these two parents these two alleles when they join together, two recessive alleles, the child or the offspring will have the disease, cystic fibrosis. So cystic fibrosis is a recessive autosomal disorder, okay? which what is the cystic fibrosis? Who is a disease that affects sweaty glands and mucosal glands? Do you understand now these two types of disorders? Yes, Murad.
Good morning, Miss.
بسيطة حبيبي.
عم نعمل ريفيجن. يعني ما بلشت درس جديد.
No, no, no.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So we now talk about the two disorders that caused on the autosomal chromosome. Now let's see other disorders that located or affected by the six-linked genes or six-linked genes. يعني they are located on the X, six chromosomes, على X. Okay? هلا males and females can differ in six-linked traits. هلا we will remember why. هلا Mendel, when he found out about the heredity, he didn't know about the chromosomes itself. Okay? Now, there are genes located على الأوتوزومز and also on the 60 chromosomes, there are genes that located there. We call them six-linked genes. The genes located on the 60 chromosomes called six-linked genes. And some disorders are caused by these genes. Now, in mammals and some other animals, individuals with XX are female and XY are male. نعرف إن الـ X chromosome لما يكون عندي 2X chromosome معناته هاي female. And if we have one X chromosome, one Y chromosome, هذولا هذا معناته male. And we learned that the X chromosome is much larger than the Y chromosome, as you see here. هاي الـ X والY. If you look here, we said that the X chromosome is larger and it has many more genes than the Y. الجين اللي في الواي هذا ايش الفانكشن تبعته؟ ان هو بس to show the characteristics of male. انه to have the characteristic of male. اما الاكس كروموسوم it have more genes. طبعا في عندي genes to show the female characteristics. In addition there are other genes that code for disorders. زي قلنا الكالر بلايندنس، نحن لما نعمل نورث الكالر بلايندنس عمل الوان نورثه مش من الاوتوزوم، يكون عندنا الجين هذا على الاكس كروموسوم. الكالر بلايندنس زي الهيموفيليا، قلنا الهيموفيليا اللي هي البلاد دازنت كلوت كويكلي افتر بليدنج، بياخذ وقت كثير تو كلوت. هدول مرضين، هدول المرضين وين بيكون الجين تبعهم؟ على الاكس كروموسوم. اوكي؟ هلا الاكسبريشن اوف سكس لينك جين دائما الميل احنا اذا في عندنا ميل وفيميل انا الميل بعرف عنده اكس واي الفيميل عندها اكس واكس الميل اونلي هاف وان كوبي اوف ايتش كروموسوم فحيكون عنده الاكس كروموسوم واحد وان اوف ذا سكس كروموسومز حيكون وان اوف ذم اكس اما الفيميل اثنين اكس سو الميل اف هي هاز only one copy لانه هو عنده اصلا one copy من X chromosome وكان على هذا الكوبي تبعه في عندي one recessive allele من ال disorder من الهيموفيليا مثلا it will express all the alleles on each chromosome لانه no second copy of other allele to mask effect of another allele بس عنده one recessive فلو طلعنا هون هذا بالكلر بلايندنس عندي المذر والفادر المذر الكلر بلايندنس لازم يكون عندي طبعا ريسيسيف اليلز تو ريسيسيف اليل تمام هلا هون هاي المذر هون الميل شوفوا البوكس هون اللي هو عندي السكوير از اميل والفيميل سيركل نورمال فيجن اللي هي نوت اللي هي كلير والشيدد هذا معناته ات هاز ذا ديس اوردر تمام هلا let's see here the sun. The sun عنده X وY لأنه male بس عنده one recessive allele. هلا for the female to have the disorder it should have two recessive alleles, C small, C small على ال X chromosome. طيب؟ هلا look here, when we cross the father is normal, ما عنده color blindness. ال X عليها C capital مش C small, dominant. المذر عندها one dominant, one recessive, يعني عندها allele of the disease, but she is a carrier, she doesn't show the disorder. Okay? When we make a cross with these two parents, حيطلع عندي one daughter normal, one daughter carrier. It doesn't show blindness, color blindness, but it's a carrier, she is a carrier. One son normal, and one son that have one recessive allele على ال X is has a color blindness. ليش؟ إنه عنده one copy من ال X, وهذا ال one copy عنده one recessive allele. There is no other copy to mask it, so it will show the and it will express the allele and show the disorder. Okay, واضح لهون؟ Any question till here, guys? No. Okay, perfect. I want to go. I will go back to this, but I want to go through something else here. So, نعمل now. بدي ناخذ شوية تفصيل عن السيكسينج جين. More details. Let's go through this one here. Just a minute. All right. Hi. هلا هون. أنا I yesterday last time I sent you the two worksheets أو study sheets. واحدة لا كل chapter 7 وفي عندي واحدة ل chapter 8 section 1 و 2. بعت لكم ياهم word document on yesterday I think. بعدين راح أبعت لكم كل الباوربوينت على البلاتفورم. بعتكم already هدول الباوربوينت will study sheet. Today I will send it on the WhatsApp. Okay, on platform, بعتهم امبارح. هلا sickling genes أو sickling inheritance. Okay, خلينا نشوف هون أنا عندي defined, إيش الـ definition اللي هو inherited conditions found on the X chromosome. Usually أغلبهم بيكونوا recessive, يعني لازم يكون عندي أنا الـ female عندها two recessive chromosomes. إذا كانت الفيميل عندها XX هلا حطوا H هون على الهيموفيليا, مرض الهيموفيليا. كابيتال لتر معناته هيلثي. إذا كان عندها واحدة كابيتال على الX والثاني عليها سمول اللي هو دوميننت ريسيسيف معناته هيلثي بات كارير. If both of the X chromosomes have two recessive alleles معناته she has the disease. الميل لا. الميل عنده 1X و1Y. إذا على الX عندي دوميننت هي إز هيلثي. إذا على X عندي one recessive يكون عنده disease. أوكي؟ هلا بيكون عندي هو rare في الفيميل أكثر في الميل. ليش؟ لأنه الفيميل بدها two recessive alleles to show the disorders. أما الميل one recessive is enough to show the disorder. تمام؟ هلا في عندي هون سؤال حاب نحله مع بعض. Jen is a healthy carrier of hemophilia. هي هاي Jen. healthy بس كارير للهيموفيليا. Adam has no history in his family. What is the probability of daughter with hemophilia? خلينا نشوف هاي عندي بنت سكوير. هاي الميل وهاي الفيميل. تمام؟ الميل is healthy but الفيميل is healthy but carrier. عملنا كروس بينهم. Let's see the offspring. أول واحدة healthy. الثانية healthy but carrier. The son كان عندي ايش؟ healthy. The last one, hemophilic. Okay? He has the disease. What is the probability of a daughter with hemophilia? واحدة منهم, كم واحدة منهم ممكن يطلع عندها هيموفيليا؟ سديل.
نعم مس.
يلا مس, بهاي الكيس أعطيني probability of daughter with hemophilia.
آخر واحدة فيها هيموفيليا معناته 25%.
هذه مس. The one I put the arrow on.
No, the one اللي بجنبها.
هاي؟
آه.
هذه boy. أنا بقول لك daughter.
Daughter ولا واحدة؟
إذن zero.
Zero.
يلا لجين. The second one. Carrier child.
We have one, which is one. The...
صح؟ قديش البرسنت يعني؟
25%.
Bravo. Child with hemophilia. Murad.
Child with hemophilia as one.
يعني قديش percent؟ One من four, معناته 25%. And all healthy children, قديش عندي healthy children the percent?
أنا 2%.
ليش؟
Because the 75%.
قديه؟ 73. هذه healthy وهذا healthy. هاي healthy but carrier بس healthy. So 75%. Okay؟ واضح يا مس؟ خلنا نشوف هاي طيب. Kelly doesn't have hemophilia even though her mother did. Jim is a hemophilic. Kelly's husband. Okay, إذن Kelly doesn't have hemophilia. ما عندها hemophilia. والhusband is hemophilic. بس إحنا Kelly بقوله doesn't have hemophilia even though her mother did. Okay, فحطوا Kelly as a carrier. يعني عندها ما عندها disease. بس her mother is have the disease, معناته maybe she is a carrier, لأنه أخذت 1X من المذر تكون carrier. والهزبند كان hemophilic, فالهزبند حيكون الX عليها recessive, والوايف اللي هي كلي حتكون carrier, واحدة, capital, واحدة small. What is the probability of getting a healthy son? قديش عندي نسبة يكون عندي healthy son? Yes, Dujain.
25.
Healthy son, 25. هاي هون غلط. الإمام ضبطها. On 25%, right? Excellent. Healthy daughter. يلا يا عبد الله. مراد.
Hello teacher.
يلا عبد الله. أعطيني probability of getting a healthy daughter.
Healthy daughter. Is it 25%?
Yes, 25. Sadie, the next one. Child with hemophilia.
Hemophilia to 50%.
Child, I didn't say.
Oh, what child one person, then 25%.
لا, child يعني. Child, male or female, I didn't say here male or female. Any child with hemophilia, 50%.
50%, yeah, okay. Yeah. Then I was
bravo, right. Okay. Carrier child, yalla, mean and how, what is the percent of having carrier child, Abdul Aziz? Okay. Abdul Aziz, carrier child. Sadil.
25% because there's only one.
Bueno, hayo.
Hayo,
girl. But girl, the boy cannot be a carrier. The sixth linked disorder, the boy, ya the male, يعني, ya imma, has a disease or is normal. ما في carrier. Yes, ya miss. Yes, Dujain.
Miss, when you ask us about like how many children are carriers, we don't count the one with the disease.
The one with disease, not طبعاً. The carrier doesn't have the disease. It doesn't show the disease. دائماً خذوها قاعدة. Carrier يعني عنده قليل مخفي. هو ما عنده المرض. بس ممكن ينقل المرض. Carrier. Okay?
Okay.
أي يعني carrier. Carrier هو مش مريض. Doesn't have the disease. بس عنده قليل. ممكن يبين المرض هذا في أولاده في الأجيال الجاي. Okay? فعشان هيك الميل دائماً بالsixth link disorder couldn't be a carrier. مستحيل يقدر يكون carrier لأنه ما في عنده another allele to hide the recessive. إذا عنده recessive, it will show that one recessive is enough to show the allele. Sorry, to show the disorder. Okay, guys. واضح. في عندي any question about this? Any question, guys? Now let's go to the next section. And the next section is the following. اللي هو section 2. Complex patterns of inheritance. I will share it with you now. Complex patterns of inheritance. We said that the phenotype is affected by many different factors. Ehna, when we learned about Mendel's findings, we learned about dominant recessive patterns. شرحنا الهيريديتي عن طريق one pattern اللي هو dominant recessive pattern. But this is not the only way how the phenotype is affected. The phenotype may be affected by many different factors. Phenotype can depend on interactions of alleles. ممكن تكون عندي interactions of alleles. عندي types of these interactions such as incomplete dominant وعندي codominant. The incomplete dominant, neither allele is completely dominant nor completely recessive. ما يكون عندي لا واحد completely dominant ولا واحد completely recessive. The heterozygous phenotype بيناتهم يكون intermediate between the two homozygous phenotypes. زي نتذكر ال wall لما يكون عندي wall when I mix them. Wall عندي أنا بعمل mixing between yellow and blue بيطلع عندي green. ف and I paint the wall with two colors but they are mixed together. فبال incomplete dominant neither allele is completely dominant لأنه the heterozygous phenotype is intermediate between the two homozygous phenotypes. زي عندي أنا هدول homozygous parents هذا parent عنده this phenotype وهذا parent عنده this phenotype. When they cross together, the offspring will have mixed between these two, and it has an incomplete dominance. تمام؟ طبعا miss هذا details in the book. هذا just revision. You have to read from the book also. Codominant or codominant alleles will both be completely expressed. The codominant alleles راح نشوف إحنا both of them are expressed. زي عندي the blood group. وزي عندي كمان another type and I didn't show it here بس موجود عندكم في الباوربوينت لما يكون عندك two flowers واحدة pink واحدة white بالcodominant pattern inheritance يكون عندي ال heterozygous offspring لما نعمل cross between these two flowers will show the alleles both of them will be expressed يعني هتطلع ال offspring اللي هي not white not pink راح تكون both راح تكون white و pink لونها okay نفس الشيء this codominant and pattern of inheritance also exists in the blood grouping قلنا and one of them that have this codominant اللي هو ال AB blood group لأنه بالblood group إحنا في عنا three allele اللي هم A capital B capital و I small okay I small letter I عليها A أو I عليها B أو I small letter. إذا كانوا اثنين A أو واحدة A capital واحدة I بيكون blood group A. إذا كانوا اثنين two alleles B capital أو واحدة B capital واحدة I small بيكون B. بس هذا إيش بيكون ال I small عندي recessive for two alleles which can bring O. ال AB لا لازم يكون عنده two antigens. Two antigens حيكون عنده A و B وحيبين في ال blood group تبعه both alleles. A و B عشان هيك في blood group هذا it follow the codominant أو codominant inheritance. في سؤال عن هذا؟ إذا هذا أول type of how the phenotypes are affected by interactions of alleles. يا عن طريق ال incomplete dominant dominant pattern أو عن طريق ال codominant pattern. هذا بيكون عندي interaction between the alleles بيناتهم بصير interaction. هلا في عندي other traits are affected by polygenes أو many genes. هذا another type بنسميهم polygenic traits. The polygenic traits produced by two or more genes. في عندي ال eye color وال skin color. ال eye color عندي في عندي three genes هنا. وعندي هون it show you what is the dominant, what is the recessive allele. بس عندي أنا more than one gene, polygenic alleles that give the color of the eye. Now, في عندي some called epistatic genes. The epistasis يكون في عندي هي a disorder that caused by epithetic gene. هذا الجين interfere with other gene as you see here in this figure. Okay. هون ال color of the fur for this animal. Hi, it is affected by 5 genes دائما. بس إذا في عندي one gene اللي هو the epithetic gene was there, it will stop all the action of other genes. رح يطلع عندي عنده مرض اللي هو إيش اسمه هذا الألبنزم. Okay. هلا the last thing إحنا we talk about إنه the environment interacts with phenotype. برضو in addition to the interactions between alleles and to the polygenic allele, في عندي كمان the environment has a role or it interacts with the genotype. برضو بتأثر على الجينوتايب. Okay. ف the phenotype that you have, the trait, the disorders that you have, it is affected by your genotype and the environment. Okay? So phenotype is a combination of genotype and environment. Any question till here, guys? Guys, any question till here? Hala, if you see here, في عندي أنا, I will show you one example. Sorry. طيب خلينا نشوف هاي الثمر الشيط. هلا هون I want to show you this summary sheet. This summary sheet is for the whole chapter 7 عشان to know. قسمت لكم اياهم section by section in one sheet. راح تلاقوا فيها هاي the revision يعني summarize for the parts and you have questions. For each section, there are questions. The answers are here. Hey, the answers in the beginning of the, each section. You will find the answer for each one. هلا نعمل to answer these two parts. Let's see this one. Yeah. Which term describes something that happens in female? Ah, في شغلة ما شرحتها اللي هي الانactivation. Who remembered? What is the inactivation? Let's go back to this one. Okay, let's review this before we start answering. There is something happen in the female sex cell. اللي هي X chromosome inactivation. Who remembered what is this? What happens in the cat here? Who remembered what the X chromosome inactivation? Yes, to Jane.
It's when one of the X chromosomes is randomly turned off.
Okay, where does this happen? Does it happen in male, female, or both?
In females.
بس بالfemales. And the females have two X chromosomes. And sometimes you see can the inactivation for one of the X chromosome. One of them turned on, one of them turned off. هذا inactivation shows some patches. زي شايفين هون patches of colors على these cats. هلا الميل doesn't have this characteristic. فالميل هون will have only the color, one color. Okay, أما هدول كلهم females. Because one of this chromosome is turned on and off. And the same here. Okay, guys? In each cell of male, one of the two X chromosomes is randomly turned off. And this is called X chromosome inactivation. And this creates these patches of two types of cells. Okay, let's go back to this one. هلا in this زي نعتبرها زي summary sheet and worksheet فيها questions والanswers موجودين. Which term describes something that happens in female mammals? Who would like to answer? Yes, to Jane?
X chromosome inactivation.
Yes. Number two, which term describes an organism that is heterozygous for a recessive autosomal disorder?
Can I?
Yes.
Not sure, but I think it's H capital and H like a recessive and a dominant. مش هيل هترو سايد.
يا سديل الانسرز ار هير، شايفين البوكس هذا؟ ايوه كارير اكس كروموسوم الاكتيفيشن وسيكستينج جين. Which term of these carrier? Which term describes an organism that is a heterozygous for recessive autosomal disorder? Bravo. عنده يعني one dominant, one recessive. And the last one, which term describes a gene that will always be expressed in males? اللي هو sex-linked gene. Look back at the figure of the autosome inheritance. The two parents are carriers of a recessive disorder called cystic fibrosis. What
wait,
is
this? Wait,
نعم
هسا يعني هو السكس لينك جين بس بالميل يعني مو بالفيميل برضه؟
لا هلا الفيميل اذا كان عندها تو ريسيسيف اليلز على الاكس كروموسوم ات ويل شو ذا ديزيز. اذا عندها واحد كابيتال واحد سمول واحد دومينانت واحد ريسيسيف بيكون كارير ما عندها ديزيز. يعني عشان تورجك ديزيز لازم يكون عندها اثنين ريسيسيف. تمام فاحتمالية يكون التنين ريسيسيف قليلة، probability أقل من الميل. الميل إذا عنده one recessive will show the disease.
Yeah, okay.
عشان هيك الميل بيكون عندهم more probability to have the sexlink disease or disorder. Do you understand?
Yes, miss. I understand.
تمام. هلأ let's see the figure. هلأ we'll go back to the figure of autosome inheritance. The two parents are carrier of a recessive disorder called cystic fibrosis. What is the probability that any of the offspring of these two parents will have the disorder? عندي أنا هيو in this figure. Let's go to this figure. It's here. عندي cystic fibrosis. Both of them are heterozygous. إيش the probability إنه the offspring will have the disorder? Who will answer this question? قديش probability يس يا زن؟
1 over 4
1 of them يا زن؟ So what is the percentage if it's one of them? Yes, Lujain?
1 over 4 said teacher.
Sorry, Yazan.
1 over 4.
1 over 4, bravo, yani 25%, صح?
Yes.
Yeah, so when I ask you of the probability, you can answer 1 over 1 to 4 or 25%. Excellent. Okay, let's see the other question here. شايفين everything is answered. هذا for section 3, نرجع على section. هلا نشوف one question in section 2. Answer a question in section 2. What is the difference between incomplete dominance and complete dominance, guys? What is the difference between incomplete dominance and codominance? What's wrong? In incomplete dominance, none of the allele will be expressed totally dominant or completely recessive. صح؟ أما بالكودومينانت both of the alleles will be expressed. Okay guys, any question till now? We will continue.